Combination therapies are becoming a part of routine evaluation in the development of every drug and treatment for every disease. To make these efforts worthwhile, intelligent study design and defined criteria of success are needed to benchmark preclinical discoveries and thus make for more successful clinical trials. For the last two decades, in vitro experimentation with cell lines has been the most important resource for investigating molecular mechanisms of disease pathogenesis. There are a number of advantages associated with the use of cell culture systems, such as availability of a wide range of human cell lines, flexibility of culture conditions, and easiness of protein or nucleic acid quantification. Additionally, in vitro tests not only evaluate the biological effects of the tested drugs, but also assess interference on the molecular and biochemical interactions. Experimental conditions for drug combination in vitro can be easily defined, fixed, or standardized. The drug concentrations can be maintained at a relatively constant during the course of the experiment, and the cell response can be easily measured. Usually, it takes approximately 1 to 2 weeks to complete an in vitro drug combination study. It is quick, accurate, and economical, and, therefore, most drug combination studies in biomedical literature have been conducted in vitro, with dose effect curves each consisting of 5 to 8 data points for each drug alone and their combinations. Compared with in vitro studies, determining synergism or antagonism in vivo using animals is obviously more time-consuming, more costly, and with greater variability in measurements. Therefore, in vivo drug combination studies are usually carried out only for selected drugs, after in vitro combination studies, and before clinical development. For a two-drug combination therapeutic studies in animals, it usually consists of 4 groups. First, the control group treated with solvent vehicle only. Second, the group treated with drug A at 3 to 4 doses. Third, the group treated with drug B at 3 to 4 doses. And fourth, the group treated with a combination of drugs A and B at a constant combination ratio, such as at the ED50 ratio, with several combination dose levels. Or at non-constant combination ratios, by keeping a constant dose of drug A, and vary the dose of drug B at several levels. Each dose is used in 4 to 5 animals. Thus, approximately 60 animals would be needed for the experiment, provided that the maximal tolerated dose, the route of administration, and the treatment schedule for each drug is already known. The length of the study would be approximately 2 to 3 months, not including the follow-up studies, if there is any. Quantitative determination of the synergism or antagonism of two drugs in clinical trials is very difficult to carry out and, in most cases, practically impossible. The complexities of clinical drug combination trials can be due to a variety of reasons. First, the patient population varies in terms of sex, age, race, stage of disease, and the history of past treatments. Second, it is not ethical to treat patients with a placebo or suboptimal therapy of doses as required for the drug combination study design. And third, death should not be allowed in clinical studies as a toxicity endpoint as in animal studies. Therefore, the success of a drug combination clinical trial would very much rely on the information provided by the in vitro and animal drug combination studies, which would include dose, schedule, route of administration, efficacy, toxicity, synergism or antagonism, and schedule dependence. There will be little or no flexibility in clinical trials. In summary, systematic screening analysis of drug combinations using in vitro or in vivo models can easily identify additive or synergistic relationships previously unrecognized. However, practically, it is not possible to determine synergism in human. One important issue raised in designing clinical trial for drug combination is whether it is ethically acceptable or scientifically correct to conduct a drug combination study in humans without doing any drug combination studies in vitro or in animals. Another issue is whether humans should be subjected to receipt of drug combination treatments under suboptimal conditions, or subjected to try-and-error testing in the absence of any supporting evidence or established rationale for the specific combinations. These issues should be confronted by clinicians who conduct drug combination trials, as well as regulatory agencies, which approves investigational new drug applications for drug combinations.